Jess has found an alternative method for disciplining his kids.
If your teenager's there going, what are you going to do? You can't hit kids. Just take a step towards them and go, it's true, you can't hit kids. I never will. You'll always be safe with me. However, if you poke me one more time, I'm going to explain in very fine detail the last time your mother and I slept together.
Welcome, Dave Thornton.
Thank you, Dave. Righto.
We love to joke. We comedy buggers. We love to make up silly premises on stage. Have you legitimately done that? Have you ever threatened, made good on the threat of talking about sex in front of your kids?
No, because I have a 5- and 7-year-old. There'd have to be an explanation of what sex is. But honestly, this is a funny reaction from someone where after my show, because I'm needy, I still hang out with audience members.
Doing surveys?
Yeah. Oh, Nick Cody was sold out. Oh, thanks for coming. Appreciate it. But I was talking to this lovely mum and her daughter, and I said, why'd you come to the show? And she said, oh, I saw the clips of you online, and she mentioned that bit, but she described it to me as, yeah, you know that bit where you said you'd have sex with your wife in front of your kids?
Oh!
And I'm like, that's not it. That is absolutely not it. So now that I've said it on TV, oh, well, goodbye to my kids. So,
that's a different taken show. Away from them.
That is. A very different, and a different time slot, Kate,
really,
if I've got to be honest.
Yes.
Probably have to do it in a different country. It's a whole different thing. Now, you've got the big tour coming up. How's the preparation going? All the warm-up gigs going all right?
Mate.
It's a favourite time of year, the warm-up gigs.
Working out the new material. I actually had a corporate, and as you all know, corporate gigs, they're always great for your confidence, guys. You know, you always sail through those bad boys. I know.
Comedy's built for conference rooms. We've been saying this.
Hey, do 20 minutes of stand-up comedy, and then we'll talk about job cuts after that. So let's have some fun.
But if you could have a giant empty dance floor in front of me while I'm performing, that'd be great.
Yeah, and this one was actually to real estate agents. Because my career's going all right.
Right.
And
okay.
It actually went okay. And so I walked off stage thinking I've done okay here. And the host of the night, she was a real estate agent. She goes, we're going to a break. And then comes backstage. And my fragile little ego was thinking, okay, she'll come up to you. Great job. And she said, you went long. And I said, sorry. And she said, you're supposed to do 20 minutes of stand-up comedy and you did 23. So you blew out the night and that's unprofessional.
What? No.
Oh, Kate, I couldn't help myself. I went, what does it feel like to be a real estate agent and have someone else go over the advertised amount? Which is a joke I thought of later, which I think is really good. You've got to agree, that's really great.
That's all. Did you put it on socials? Because I noticed you've been on socials a lot lately.
Have I what? You're not answering those DMs I slipped through, Kate.
Well, you know, just the occasional eggplant emoji. You know.
Well, from you, not
hang on.
My problem is mine's not shaped like an eggplant, so I don't get it.
Screw.
It's a big callback. If you're only just joining us for Dave's bit, really funny callback from earlier in the show.
An hour ago.
Hey, but on socials are like real estate agents, like a lot of hatred.
Oh, yeah.
But you're not getting the hatred. Have you learned how to deal with it?
No, there's still idiots. I mean, there's idiots that will probably, once they put these clips up, they'll always, rather than just scrolling through.
Yes.
But my thought is, because you don't know who's writing the comments, that's the thing that I hate, because it's a faceless crime. I think people should be IQ tested and then allocated a certain font. You know, so if you read a comment in like Times New Roman Gold Embossed, it's Waleed's on the socials.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Waleed's joined.
But if you read something in Wingdings, you're like, I thought Trump was off Twitter. Like, what's going on? You know,
Comic Sans, that would be my go-to for trolls.
I thought that'd be your go-to for fun.
I was like, this makes sense.
That is.
Yeah.
That
Rome's back on.
And unfair.
Oh, it's Comic Sans and a corkscrew. Nice.
Now, I wanted to bring up some classic footage I was looking through over the weekend because I haven't been busy at all. Of your, I think it might have been your first TV appearance back in the day on my old talk show.
Oh, yeah, on Rove?
Yes.
Yes. Well, actually, this is a little fun fact, mate. You know, my first ever stand-up comedy spot was in this studio circa 2004. Bert on Good Morning Australia.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
How did you do?
Between Belvedere and Moira. I was doing a little bit of stand-up.
With an audience of no one. Let's have a look at you when you got much better, but not with the hair. Check out the haircut, not mine. Look at this young buck. I've never seen you clean shaven in a long time.
And look at that fringe. Is horrific, isn't it?
I don't think I've
ever seen you clean shaven.
No, you know, not only do I have that fringe, that's
a short spot. It's free.
Yeah, that's how I wore my pubes. just across down. Like, but the thing is, you haven't aged a day. That's the weird thing.
Exactly the same.
But I do appreciate you taking me on since I left My Chemical Romance. I really appreciated.
You're very emo. You're so emo.
It was very emo, wasn't it?
Yeah.
What a horrific look. You know, my wife's in the audience tonight.
If her and the tunnies together.
If we met when I had that fringe, she'd be like, we're not having kids. Nothing's happening. I'm shutting down shop.
Nothing impossible is heading to a comedy festival near you. Yes. Ticket information is all on our website. Make sure you get a ticket.
That's it for tonight. Thank you, Kate and Nick, for joining us. Reece City Cook is next, and the sun.